गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? होप ऑल आर यू बेटर एंड डूइंग योर स्टडी वेल। नाउ टुडे हियर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस इन टेस्ट एनसीईआरटी एक्सरसाइज। लास्ट टाइम वी हैव बीन फिनिश्ड आवर थ्योरी पोर्शन ऑफ द चैप्टर नंबर 9, दैट इज फोर्सेस एंड लॉज ऑफ मोशन। नाउ टुडे हियर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द इन टेस्ट एक्सरसाइज ऑफ आवर चैप्टर। So here the first question from the our first in test exercise is, which of the following has more inertia? I have told about the inertia. Inertia is basically the measure of mass. The object which have greater mass will have greater inertia. So here the first question is, are our ball and a stone of the same size? As we know, the mass of the stone will be large and therefore the inertia of stone will be large. Now the second B part, a bicycle and a train. As we know, the mass of train is very large as compared to the mass of a bicycle. So the inertia of bicycle will be large as compared to, the inertia of train will be large as compared to bicycle because its mass is greater. Now the C part, a 5 rupee coin or a 1 rupee coin. As we know, the mass of a 5 rupee coin is greater and therefore inertia of a 5 rupee coin will be greater. Now the question number 2. In the following example, try to identify the number of times the velocity of the ball changes when a footballer kicks the ball to the another player of his team, and then who kicks the football towards the goal and goalkeeper of the opposite team collect the football and back it kick towards the player of his own team. Also identify the agent of the spline force in this case. You can see here you have been asked a football, how many times the football was kicked. First of all, whenever a player kick the ball, whenever a footballer kick the ball towards the another player of his team, and then his second player of his team kick the football towards the goal and goalkeeper kick the football of the second player of his own team, of the other player of his own team. So here first of all the football player kick the ball towards the player of his team, then the player of his team kick the ball towards the goalkeeper, and then goalkeeper firstly stops the goal and then kick it towards the player of his team. So here 4 times the velocity of the ball changes. First it was changed by the player of a team, and then secondly his own team by kicking towards the goal, and then goalkeeper stops third time, and then fourth time goalkeeper kick the ball towards the player of his own team. So here the velocity of the ball changes 4 times. Now the next question, why some of the leaves may get detached from a tree whenever the tree shake, when we shake the branch of the tree vigorously, which means whenever the branch of a tree shake very strongly, then some of the leaves from the tree get detached. Why it was happen? Because whenever we shake that branch of tree very vigorously, then due to the inertia of rest, the leaves tends to remain at the position of rest, but the motion has come and they want to remain at their previous position and get detached. Due to the inertia of rest, they get detached from there. Now the question number 4 is, why do you fall forward direction when a moving bus brakes to stop and fall backward when it accelerates from the rest. So whenever a moving bus stops by applying brake, we will fall in forward direction due to the inertia of a motion. But whenever a bus starts from the rest suddenly or accelerate from the rest, then we will fall in backward direction due to the inertia of rest, and we will try to remain at rest whenever bus accelerate, and that's why we will fall in backward direction. But whenever bus is moving in forward direction and driver apply brakes, we will fall in forward direction because of the inertia of a motion. Because due to the inertia of motion, our body try to remain in the state of motion, and due to which we will fall in forward direction. Because after applying the brakes, bus, the motion of the bus has stops, but our body will try to remain in the motion due to the inertia of a motion, and we will fall in forward direction. Now the next is, if the action is always equal to the reaction, explain why a horse pull the cart. As we know, a horse pull the cart in forward direction, and at the same time, according to third law of motion, cart must pull the horse in backward direction. But at the same time, horse apply the force on the ground with his feet, and this force give the further forward reaction to the horse, and it is able to move with the cart in the forward direction. Now the next question, question number sixth, explain why it is difficult for a fireman hold a hose which ejects a large amount of water with a high velocity. Because this happens due to the third law of motion. Because whenever water ejects with a high speed from the hose or a pipe, then it will exert a force in forward direction, and according to third law of motion, it will give a reaction force in backward direction, and this reaction force causes difficulty to hold the hose or the pipe, and that's why they feel difficult to catch the pipe or the hose. Now the next question, number 7, a rifle of mass 4 kg is fired. A rifle of mass 4 kg having a bullet of mass 50 gram with and fired with initial velocity 35 meter per second, we have to calculate what will be the recoil velocity of the gun here or the rifle here. Here mass of the bullet is 51 gram, that is M1, and mass of the rifle is M2, that is 4 kg. Here U1 and U2 both are 0. U1 means the velocity of the gun before the firing the bullet, and the velocity of the bullet before firing. So before firing the bullet, both gun and bullet are at rest. But whenever bullet was fired, then bullet move in forward direction with a velocity of 35 meter per second. It will be V1, and we have to determine what does the recoil velocity of the gun, that is V2. According to the principle of conservation of energy, as we know, M1 U1 plus M2 U2 must be equal to M1 V1 plus M2 V2. So here both U1 and U2 are 0 because the gun and the bullet both are at rest before the firing. Now our equation become like this. Since both U1 and U2 are 0, therefore M1 V1 plus M2 V2 must be equal to 0, because U1 and U2 are 0 because our bullet and the gun both are at rest before the firing. So here we have to determine V2 is the recoil velocity of the bullet, and V2 is the recoil velocity of the gun, and M2 is the mass of the gun or the rifle, and V1 is the velocity of bullet, and M1 is the mass of the bullet. So here V2 must be equal to, we will take M1 V1 in the right hand side, it will become negative, and it will become M1 V1 minus of M1 V1 divided by m2. Here m1 is the mass of a mass of bullet, that is 50 gram, and we have to change it in kilogram, and v1 is a velocity, that is 35 meter per second, and m2 is the mass of a gun, that is 4 kg, and we will put all the values in this formula, that is minus m1 v1 divided by m2, and we will get our answer from here, and it will be minus 7 by 16 meter per second after solving. And here this negative sign basically indicates that the gun recoils in backward direction, which means the velocity or the recoil velocity of the gun is always opposite to the direction of a bullet. Now the next question, it is the last question of our in-test exercise, and it is the question number 8 from the second or the last blue box. Two objects of masses 100 gram and 200 gram are moving with the same direction, and their velocities are 2 meter per second and 1 meter per second, and they collide, and after the collision the first object starts moving with velocity 1.67 meter per second, and we will have to determine the velocity of the second. So here we are given m1, that is 100 gram, m2, that is 200 gram, and the velocity, initial velocity of our first object m1 is 2 meter per second, and u1 is 2 meter per second, and u2 is 1 meter per second, and here v1 is given 1.67 meter per second after the collision, and the v2, that is the velocity after the collision, we have to determine. So according to principle of a conservation of a angular momentum, m1 u1 plus m2 u2 must be equal to m1 v1 plus m2 v2. So here m1 is 100 gram and u1 is 2 meter per second, m2 is 200 gram and u2 is 1 meter per second, m1 again 100 gram and v1 is 1.67 meter per second, m2 again 200 gram, and v2 we have to determine. So here we have to convert gram into kilogram by dividing it 1000, and it will become 1 by 10, and it will become 2 by 10, and we can put all the values here. M1 is 1 by 10 and u1 is a 2 meter per second, and this is a m2, that is 2 by 10 and it is 1 meter per second, and m1 is again 1 by 10 and its and v1 is 1.67 meter per second, and m2 is 2 by 10 and v2 we have to determine. So by putting all the values in this equation, that is the equation from the principle of conservation of a momentum, we can determine the value of a v2 after the calculation or after solving it. So in this way we can determine the values of a v2 or the velocity of the second object after the collision. So this was all about the in test exercise of a chapter number 9, that is forces and laws of a motion. So hope all you get or understood all the numericals very well. Thank you, students.